Alright people, beta's coming to a close, so I figure I might as well make some last videos. Now I've showed you plenty of videos on the terrain editing, so you can see it's kind of like painting a brush, right? We know that, I'm undoing, okay. Now, what I didn't describe in detail was the advanced terrain sculpting. This could be a long video, so I'm going to explain a lot of the things I did not explain before. The difference is, well, lots of differences. Instead of painting it like additively, you make an absolute position for the terrain. See? You exactly how you want it, you sculpt an exact height, so this can give you very precise control over your environment. Okay? You know, any of the features in the regular brush, I imagine, will also be present here in the full game. And what's really cool is you can tilt it. For example, see, I'm tilting the brush, which is really cool, because you can make some very original shapes, I guess, with this feature that you might not be able to do otherwise. Alright, let's see what else we can do with the terrain editing. We can also change the surface. For example, maybe I want this to be muddy, or maybe like this kind of grass. Just paint it on. Works great. And it blends the edges together. This is just an example of what you can, what you are able to do. And you can also add grass. Beautiful grass, and I assume there's going to be more options for this ground cover in the full game. Alright, so let's make a track from scratch. Okay, that's beautiful and all, but I want to make things a little more exciting. This turn, I want to get rid of this mountain. I want to make a great hazard here. Let's see what I can do. I want to make a great hazard right here. What's gonna go on? There's gonna be like a kind of cliff here, I guess. Let me use the advanced sculpt. Okay. Showing you all what it is, might as well actually put it to use. And of course, I can tilt it. Bear with me, come on. altogether this long on this YouTube channel, just bear with me. Great hazards. Just eroded a little bit. Alright, so that looks like a little bit different now. What's gonna happen, I'm gonna make this a bank. Turn, the turn will be bank. Edit, my track. That's edit. This is going to be a very nasty turn, and if you don't think it's nasty yet, just give me a sec. Watch this. My track, road styles. I'm going to erase the inner. Border. See that? So this is a very nasty turn, and you can really get hurt here badly. Oh yes. And you know what? Maybe I want the same thing right there. You know, a little danger, like. A little bit about what dynamic props are and how they work. Now, almost everyone who's tried the beta has probably encountered these ramps, but I don't know if everyone is fully aware of how powerful they are. Let me show you. Alright. Now, I put that down and that's all well and good, but we can actually alter its properties. All dynamic objects can have the properties altered and can be linked to triggers for certain events, but we don't have access to that in the beta. Okay, so we can actually alter the angle of the ramp, and we can animate it. Actually, we can, so it goes up and down. If we had a trigger, we can set it to off. Maybe something could trigger the ramp to activate. So if we go to both of these, because even if the ramps aren't here, we want to go fast. And if we look in preview mode, we'll see that these ramps animate. So they will go flying. Alright. Guess it's time to just finish up and let her rip.